Hi, okay. So I'm going to talk about kind of the recent addition to my eccentric camera collection. This is a Fujica Rapid S2 camera. Whoop, there it is over there. It's a 35mm aperture priority rangefinder camera that works on the Rapid system, which was a 35mm system that was in competition with Kodak's 1.26 film format, which is a really bizarre format I've never used that I don't even know if it's still in use, actually. It's like a weird asymmetric thing where the canister is actually like, rather than the usual cassette that that you just pull film out of, it actually already has the film pulled out into another like sort of take-up reel kind of thing, and you put it, you kind of sandwich it in. It's very interesting. Rapid is the same, is the same kind of principle. You're meant to load two cassettes in rather than just loading one in. That's gonna get pulled back in a take-up. You're gonna load both a canister that has film in it and an empty canister. Empty canister. In general, the using the Fujica and using the Rapid system is kind of like an alien experience because suddenly there's like a bunch of controls missing that you're used to. Like you're used to seeing like your take up, like that kind of system, and this is just like all blank. Like there's like nothing going on here. There's nothing over here. What are you supposed to do? So that's the first thing, is that you're gonna be using the system, and you can still use 35mm that you get now. You can fill 12 in here. It's a square format, so it's 24 by 24mm. It's not technically a half frame, I don't think, really, because like they don't. One problem with the Rapid is it leaves quite a margin between each of the exposures. Let me see if I can actually show you here. This is a film strip I shot with it, and you can see, or maybe you can see, it's a little hard. You can see here that there's like quite a margin between each of these exposures. So I've seen square format cameras that have less of a margin, and I guess that's a good way to save film. But anyway, this one manages to film this way. So you can see there's the square format. It's very interesting. Outside of the Rapid system, there's not that much to do square format 35mm. There's the Texona 10X. There's the Robot series, which is a personal favorite of mine. That's kind of another weird cult camera. The Robot Royale and the Robot Recorder are a couple of my favorites. The Royale especially is, I would say, as beautiful, if not more beautiful, than a Leica M3, but I won't say anything that will get me in trouble. And interestingly enough, the robots were used as spy cameras in East Germany because they could be, they had like a wind on them, and then you could hide them. Yeah, anyway, so really, square format in general on 35mm is kind of an interesting story, if you're a camera dork. So the only problem with the, so okay, so the first thing you're missing is like your take-up stuff, and then you're suddenly gonna look and you're gonna be like, all right, so how do I do the film speed? Because there's also nothing to change that. So you're like, all right, so how does that work? Well, the just as the I mean, there have been other systems that have done this, but this is the only one I've ever used. It actually uses the cassettes to tell the camera the film speed. For the most part, what you're gonna find are cassettes of the B size. I've never really seen anything higher than an E cassette. I think I have an E cassette. Maybe. Anyway, the higher you go with the letter, and the higher this, you can see there's sort of a bump in that. There's like a little like T part there that's going up. The longer that is, the higher ISO it's telling the camera it is. Because the cameras were designed to recognize up to 400 speed, what I did was simply, there's like kind of a little lever inside here that is just, it's, there's nothing electrical about it. It's just based on pressure. Like, this little thing pushes it down a certain amount because that's the millimeter length. If you wanted to use something like 200 speed or, you know, something other than 400 speed, I mean, God help you, you have to kind of measure out how many millimeters. And I have found a guide online to do that. But so what I did was, because I'm just using 400, and that's the max, I just smooshed the whole the thing down all the way. Do it again here. And then that way the camera just read it as 400 speed all the time, which works perfectly well. This camera, the way that it meters is a little odd. I'll give you an example. From shooting inside of a darker room out to a brighter window, you know, like an afternoon sun window, it actually metered for the room, and I was like 12 feet away from the window. But the window took up the whole frame. That's what's interesting. So that was a little odd. It explains why, you know, you have the ability to change your apertures. And I guess you can use kind of a Sunny 16 rule and hope that the camera can figure out the right shutter speed. I've never heard it go slower than what sounded like maybe 1/60th of a second, possibly 1/30th of a second, because it opens to 2.8. With 400 speed, that's enough for most situations where underneath that you would be getting camera shake anyway. But personally, I really like slower speeds. So that was kind of a bummer for me with this camera. But if you're using it for like street photography or something, it would work quite well. Other things to mention about it, it has a PC cable, so the socket there. There you go. So you can see. So you can use a flash with it. I assume it's a cold shoe. Yeah, I mean, I think it's aesthetically a really beautiful camera. You know, it's kind of got a sleek, odd shape. The top here, yeah, kind of a rounded shape here. And it does hold very well in the hand. A couple of things, is very heavy though. Like, you could like really hammer somebody with this thing. And when you're loading, when you're unloading the film, so this is the final sort of warning I'll give when you're using the Rapid system. So because it's just winding into a take-up cassette here, the last frame of the film doesn't actually get pushed into the cassette. So you're going to want to open it in darkness and physically, with, you know, just push that last frame in. Otherwise, you just lost a frame for no reason. Yeah, I would definitely give Rapid a try. It's a really interesting format. It has a really weird history, and these cameras go for fairly cheap on eBay when they do come up, which is not very common, but they do. To me, the best use for this camera, because of the way the Rapid system works in terms of you just can, you know, switch the cartridges around, you know, over and over again, is it's great actually for doing multiple exposures. It's not terribly precise in having like a one-to-one correspondence of each, you know, square on top of another square. I haven't really been able to get it to do that, but I have had it do, like, I have essentially exposed every single, you know, micron of a strip of film with single and double exposures, and it looks really beautiful. It looks really interesting. So my suggestion is, if you enjoy doing multiple exposure work and you would like to do multiple exposure work with an interesting film format like the Rapid Square, definitely give it a shot. It's definitely worth trying. The cheapest way to get the cassettes is actually not to buy them by themselves. I find they tend to get marked up. I mean, if you can find them for like $5 or under for a cassette, get it. But a lot of times people charge for like $20, which is ridiculous. In which case, the best thing to do is you can actually just get, they had like a little disposable, like kind of trashy toy version, which was the Agfa ISO flash rapid camera. And a lot of times you can still get those in the box or with cassettes still in it. And a lot of times those sell cheaper than buying the cassettes by themselves, because people know that the cassettes are worth something. Anyway, that's my last little bit of advice about using the Rapid system and the Fujika Rapid S2 camera.